Hi, my name is Kyle Chester-Marsden and welcome to our how-to series here at Fieldpiece Instruments. Today, I'll be showing you how to view air measurements from the Fieldpiece psychrometers directly on the SMAN manifold. So the first thing we need to do is to ensure all of our devices are powered on and that the tools are within the wireless range. A good time to remind you that the JobLink enabled products such as the manifold and the psychrometers have a wireless range of over 300 meters, so we shouldn't see any issues here today. So we power all the tools on by pressing and holding the power button on each tool until the display lights up on the manifold and until the green LED flashes on the power button on the psychrometers. Finally, we press the power on button on the manifold one more time to illuminate the backlit display. So once we have everything powered on, we need to ensure that the wireless functionality is turned on the manifold itself. And to do this, we simply press and hold the wireless on-off button on the manifold. And once we see the display show the little wireless symbol next to the on, then we know we're good to carry on. And so to ensure the psychrometers are synced to the manifold, we need to go into the menu items and find wireless sources. So to do this, we just press the menu button, and then we scroll using the up or down arrows and find wireless sources, and hit enter. The S-Man will always default to looking for a wireless psychrometer as the first tool it looks to connect to, which in our case is perfect because that's what we're looking to connect to here. And you'll see that we have this little flashing R symbol. That just means that the manifold is currently looking for a return psychrometer. And so to select this and confirm that this is what we're going to search for, we just need to press enter one more time on the manifold, and then this will start scanning for a return psychrometer in the area. And so as you can see there, it's found a psychrometer with an ID number of 4187, and we can just check the back of the psychrometer to confirm that this is the correct unit that we are going to connect to by cross-referencing that ID number. Once we're happy with this, we can go ahead and hit enter one more time to save that wireless connection and move on to the next one, the supply psychrometer, hence the little S you see there on the screen. So we just go through the same process we just described, once again confirming that the psychrometer matches this ID number, so we press enter. You see there ID 9000 is being read by the manifold, and we can just cross-reference that again on the supply psychrometer. Once we're happy, we press enter to save the selection. Once we've done this, we can actually hit the menu button to exit back to the home screen, as we now have both of those psychrometers connected. And so what you'll notice when we go back to the home screen is that the screen is not displaying any of the psychrometric values and is instead displaying the outdoor dry bulb temperature, the suction line temperature, and the liquid line temperature in the middle column. So in order to display the values from the connected wireless psychrometers, we must first press the air button on the manifold, and this will then scroll through all of the available measurements that are currently being taken by these tools. So as we press the air button, you will see the first measurement, and that is dry bulb temperature. And so now you can see those values are now populated in the center column on the screen. If we press the air button again, it scrolls through to the next measurement, which is wet bulb temperature. If we press the air button again, we go through to dew point value. If we press it again, this will show us the relative humidity percentage. One more time, the enthalpy value readouts. And then finally, we press one more time, and this shows us the return dry bulb versus supply dry bulb with the target delta T and delta T readings in the middle column there. If we then press air one last time, this takes us full circle and displays the suction line and liquid line temperatures that the temperature clamps here on the side of the manifold are measuring. So, there you have it. That's how to view the air temperature measurements using our JL3RH psychrometers, linking directly with our SMAN manifolds. Thanks for watching and stay tuned for more great videos.